friends, and welcome to the Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam, and it's great to have you with us for this special retrospective as we focus on some great endings to SDSU football games. This week, we'll highlight the game-winning drive of four Jackrabbit Classics. And we begin with 1999. SDSU was 6-3 and led by one of the top running backs in Division II, Josh Ronick. In-state rival USD sported a 3-6 mark, but featured a future NFL rusher in Jamel White. Ronick had scored three times, but White countered with two himself. And with just under 6 minutes remaining, USD took over at its own 23-yard line, leading 30-28. Tom Niemann and John Wilson called the game on Kelloland 16 years ago.
Straight ahead again, Weister, the fullback. And Northern Colorado, North Dakota State playing each other out in Greeley this afternoon. White this time, knocked down after a short gain, just inside the 40. Third and five, big play here for the Jackrabbit defense as they need to get the ball back. They trail it by two. Delay, White, nothing doing this time. Maybe got a yard, but 2 minutes and 33 seconds now, and they'll run it down as far as they can. Finally, 2:30 left. When the snap comes, Barron will get a return from his own 26-yard line. And not much doing there. And again, another pass swatted at the line. Clock stopped at 2:18 after the incomplete pass. Looking long, he's got Barron, and that's going to be a definite pass interference penalty. And again, he was beat on the play. It was Burwell again. Missed the field goal on the last possession. Good catch again by Chris Gary. SDSU from their own 47-yard line. Spread it out. Ronick, the only back left. And they'll give it to him. Pull the guard out. Ronick busting into the USD secondary. Uh-oh. Can he be caught? They've got an angle on him. And Stamer comes over. Touchdown, Ronick.
Unbelievable.
53 yards for the touchdown.
I was just going to say, University of South Dakota, they were kind of looking for the pass. Josh Ronick, the only back in the backfield. And you see the guards pulling right there. Boom. He breaks out, and you aren't going to catch him.
So with a minute 54 on the clock, Ronick goes 53 yards. So a four-point South Dakota State lead. They'll go for two to try to make it at least a touchdown lead, and they get the conversion to Chris Paul. And instead, he puts a rug burner out there, taken short at the 21-yard line. And out over the 33-yard line, they spread it out. Go to the air with Justice. And that's one way, I guess. Oh! Casey Hillman comes up and picks it off for the Jackrabbits. And that is going to seal it up. Justice was looking for White out of the backfield, and Hillman saw it coming all the way. And a flag at the end of the play might be for celebration, but it will not negate the touchdown return by Casey Hillman.
And it almost looked like the ball was tipped, but it wasn't tipped. It was just thrown up in the middle of a couple of Coyote receivers and Casey Hillman.
Second interception return of the season for Hillman. He had a big one against Augustana to help him win that football game. That makes it 42-30. And again, Hillman, the sophomore from Sioux Falls, O'Gorman.
Ronick finished with 254 yards on 31 carries, scoring four touchdowns, including that game-winning 53-yard scamper with just 154 remaining. Up next, we look back at the 2006 Hobo Day game against UC Davis when this special edition of the Jackrabbit Insider returns.
Sumner pump fake. He'll throw down the right side. Caught! Touchdown, Brandon Huber! And the Jackrabbits win it in double OT!
Soil is the foundation and the future.
Healthy soil has a lot of organic matter. Good soil is alive.
We've seen our organic matter increase steadily each year.
As a farmer, I care about the land.
We have to care about the land.
Soil is the foundation of everything.
I'm Steve Halverson.
Al Miron.
I'm Jeff Lochner.
This is Farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Our Jackrabbit Insider special featuring some of the great endings in SDSU football history continues. It was October 28, 2006, Hobo Day here on campus, as a pair of 4-3 teams met in an important Great West Football Conference showdown. The visiting Aggies built up a 21-7 halftime lead, but the Jacks rallied. A third quarter goal line stand kept the game within striking distance, and this Andy Cardew's Chris Wagner touchdown brought the Jacks within 21-16. That was the score when SDSU regained possession with just 6:52 remaining in the game, first and 10 at its own 9. Steve Emming, Jerry Oster, and Scotty Quaz of the Jackrabbit Sports Network and WNAX were on the call.
Watson in the backfield. Jerron Harris comes back in motion from left to right, then retraces his steps. And on first down from the 9, they'll hand it off to Watson up the middle across the 10, bounced it ahead to the 15, and dropped there after a gain of about 6. Watson in the backfield here, out of the shotgun, Cardews. Cardews takes the snap, going to hand it off again, but Watson's hemmed in, trying to get outside, got some running room to about the 15, and then he is going to fall forward for a yard out of bounds at the 16, which will leave the Jacks with a third down and about 3. Third and 3 at his own 16-yard line. Cardews, here comes the blitz. Cardews throws left side, got a man, Johnson at the 25. Micah to the 30, to the 34, and a first down. Micah Johnson put a heck of a move on Nevin Bergen, twisted him all around, and Johnson gets the reception and the first down to the 34.
You know, Bergen fell down. If Micah gets himself repositioned and Andy hits him, he's gone, because Bergen was on the ground when that ball was thrown.
Cardews on first down, play action. He wants to throw, looking, can't find anybody. Now he looks for Harris. He caught it, 45, up to the 48, 49, a first down. Jerron Harris waited and waited, and the quarterback, Andy Cardews, waited and waited for him to shake free, and he finally did and was able to haul in the pass for a first down at the 49-yard line. On first down from their own 49, long count by Cardews. He's going to hand it off. Watson trying to come up the middle, found some room inside the 45, and finally brought down at the 43. Another strong run by Watson to pick up about 8 yards. On second and short, Cardew's going to try to throw. He's in trouble, though. He's going to have to get rid of it. He pulls it down. He laddled it off. Here's Watson inside the 45 to the 40, and a first down at the 39-yard line. A little shovel pass by Andy Cardews, who was about to be sacked by Mike Ng, and he just underhanded it to Watson, who picks up the first down. Out of the shotgun, Cardews with 3 wideouts, 2 to the right side. Koenig, the running back, alongside him. Cardews takes the snap, rolls to the right side, wants to throw, throws it to the sideline for Harris, too high, incomplete, and Harris was hit. And here comes a flag.
Yeah, he was completely unprotected. He went up for the ball. He was hit after the ball went by. No need for any contact there.
Watson, the running back, alongside of Cardews. Jacks 5 down. They need a touchdown. And Cardews out of the shotgun will take the snap, hand it off up the middle. Andy on the keeper to the 25, maybe the 24. He faked the handoff to Watson and then got up the middle and was able to pick up significant yardage. And Cardews working under center. Cardews with a long count again. Andy takes the snap, play action, wants to throw, looks, fires it right side. Harris caught it, 15-yard line, and out of bounds at the 14. Well, they say stayed in bounds, but it is a first down That'll stop the clock momentarily with 2:28 to go. And again, Cardews looking over the defense, uses the long count. And Cardews on first down takes the snap. He'll hand it to Watson. Comes left, cuts it back, gets to about the 11.
It's all right. Good run and play there. Keep him honest.
There was a hole there. Flag comes in. Oh. Some pushing and shoving. Somebody's going to get caught with a stupid penalty.
Nick Flessner this time came up holding his hands up. Oh, boy, that'd be critical right here.
So who did they catch? Personal foul, South Dakota State.
Ooh.
Get the penalty, but it came after the play, so they lose the down. It's second down from the 26 of UC Davis. The Jacks have to get to the 4-yard line for a first down. Andy will take the snap on second and long, roll to the right side, looking to throw, can't find anybody, has to pull it down. He'll heave it now late and incomplete. Low intended for Micah Johnson, well covered on the sidelines there by Adam Cook. Need a big conversion here. Cardews will take the snap, drop to throw, has time, steps up in the pocket, fires it over the middle, caught by Snyders at the 9, but he's down immediately, and it's going to be a big fourth down here. Fourth and 5 coming up. Dusty was wide open, but unfortunately had a dive to the ground to make the catch. Watson alongside Cardews, who will work out of the shotgun. They need at least 5 to keep their hopes alive. Cardews will take the snap, looks to throw, fires it right side, and it's going to be caught! Dusty Snyders, touchdown!
Yes!
Dusty Snyders caught it in traffic and got into the end zone for the touchdown with 1:08 to go.
Dusty Snyders caught it at about the 3-yard line, got a hand down and crawled forward. Scotty, what a call down there.
He had the first down, and that's a second effort there by Dusty Snyders. Makes the catch, keeps his one hand down, and gets upfield.
22-21 the final as the Jacks won their 5th of 7 straight, finishing that 2006 season at 7-4. Next, a pair of fourth down conversions lead to an improbable final second win on the road. We look back at the 2012 victory at Southern Illinois after you look at this Jackrabbit legend.
4-year closer J.D. Moore, the all-time saves leader at SDSU, is this week's Jackrabbit legend presented by Legend Seeds. The Canadian righty stepped into the closer role as a freshman and saved 5 games. He came into his own as a sophomore, though, establishing a new single-season saves mark by closing the door 13 times with a 1.99 earned run average as the Jacks won the Summit League Championship and advanced to the NCAA tournament. Moore went 4-3 with 8 saves and a 3.07 ERA his junior year and finished his career with 6 saves, 2 wins, and a 2.89 earned run average. His 32 career saves obliterated the previous school mark, and he ranked 2nd on the career appearance list with 86. Reliever J.D. Moore, a Jackrabbit legend. This Jackrabbit legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Luan takes the snap with 43. He'll throw deep right side, underthrown for Snyder, who makes a tremendous leaping catch. What a play by the senior from Andover, Minnesota, and the Jacks are back in front.
The specialists are so important because they're the ones that can take your team from average to great. The guys that have their specialized roles and understand them and do them really well, those guys are hard to find. And so when you have those guys that are good at what they do and believe in what they're doing, don't care too much about who gets the credit and want to go out and prove something, I think that is probably the most important ingredient in a successful team.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
It's record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties! And we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans. Agronomy, answers, yield.
Jackrabbit fans, if you notice our students doing a chant, join along with them. It creates a great home court advantage for us.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great. More of this special Jackrabbit Insider highlighting some fantastic finishes in SDSU football lore. On November 3rd, 2012, 6-3 SDSU was fighting to stay atop the Missouri Valley Football Conference when it took the field in Carbondale, Illinois against the 5-4 Salukis of Southern Illinois. SDSU's offense struggled to find a rhythm, but three Justin Sirovatka field goals and some excellent defense kept SDSU within striking distance. Trailing 12-9 with 2:55 to play, sophomore quarterback Austin Sumner would have one final chance to lead the Jacks to the win, starting at his own 6-yard line.
Jacks have three receivers left, one to the right, center to the right of Sumner in the shotgun. Sumner takes the snap, drops into his own end zone, looking. He'll throw over the middle for Rollin. Behind him, incomplete, nearly intercepted. It was behind Rollin. It was in the hands of Emmanuel Sorin. If he hangs on to it, it's ball game. Sumner in the gun, three left, one right, back to throw. He'll find Rollin left sideline to the 10. Rollin out of bounds near his own 12-yard line. Third and four, left hash at his own 12. 2:29 to play. Three-step drop, quickly throws to Schneider, makes the catch, dives out across his own 18. First down, SDSU, their side, center to the left of Sumner. Drops to throw, Sumner quickly throws left side, Schneider makes the catch. He is tripped up by Emmanuel Sorin. Jacks have three wide to the right and one to the left. Sumner in the gun. Clock in motion, bad snap, it's past Sumner. He'll have to dive on it, back at the 10-yard line. Sumner wasn't ready for the snap, and it went flying by him. And now the Jacks are in real trouble. Three wide right and one to the left. Sumner makes his call, drops to throw. He's flush left, looking, still looking. He'll throw deep left side, has a man open, and it is caught. It hung up forever, but it was caught by Trevor Tiefenthaler, who looked more like a punt returner than a receiver. He makes the catch at the 33. It's a 22-yard completion on 4th and 19. We are under a minute to play. The Jacks have a fourth and a long eight, two wide either side of their own 35-yard line. Sumner takes the snap. He'll throw over the middle. Wide open, Rollin, first down and more to midfield. He stutter-stepped, thinking there was somebody else there. Otherwise, he could have gotten more. Two wide either side, second and 10 from midfield. Sumner goes deep over the middle for Rollin, who hangs on inside the 30. He's down to the Southern 27-yard line with 37 seconds left. 23-yard completion. The Jacks hustle to the line of scrimmage. Sumner makes his call, clock to 35 seconds. Sumner drops to throw, looking flush right, throws to Zenner out of the backfield, who tried to tightrope the sidelines. He picked up four, he's out of bounds at the SIU 23. Two wide either side, Sumner a three-step drop, looks to throw, pressured, he throws to the right sideline, pass is caught, Trevor Tiefenthaler, who is out of bounds inside the 19 of SIU. It'll be third and a yard with 22 seconds left. Kuhl and Hubert wide left. Zenner to the right of Sumner on third down and a long one. Sumner to throw. Looks right. Throws that way. Caught Tiefenthaler, who dives out of bounds at the Southern Illinois 12. It's first and 10 Jackrabbits. Sumner dropping to throw. Pressure throws to Zenner out of the backfield inside the 10. Puts his shoulder down inside the 5, and he's out of bounds. They'll mark him back to the SIU 3-yard line. Rollin and Tiefenthaler right, Hubert and Kuhl to the left. Zenner to the right of Sumner. Sumner takes the snap, in trouble, rolls left side, gets away, throws to the end zone. Touchdown, South Dakota State! Trevor Tiefenthaler with 7 seconds left, and the Jackrabbits have come back from the dead to take a 15-12 lead.
A drive for the ages, 18 plays, 94 yards in 2 minutes, 55 seconds. And to add to that, Sumner actually threw for 110 yards on that drive. SDSU has made four straight playoff appearances, and that run likely never starts if not for that drive on a gray November day in Illinois. We've got one more finish to cover, SDSU's dramatic 20-08 win at North Dakota State, when this special Jackrabbit Insider continues.
Bison show blitz, then back off. Nelson back under pressure. He's hit, but throws. He's got Molitor inside the 15, inside the 10, inside the 5. He's going to score!
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Farmers are paying more attention to water quality and making it a priority.
Every farm is different and every farmer is different, but everyone wants to do what's right for the environment. We're conserving the water, the limited water that we do get, and we're not wasting it.
The individual farmer has to be proactive.
No-till allows our crops to use all the water that we are blessed to receive.
We keep water clean.
For the people of South Dakota, it's about doing the right thing.
I am Al Miron.
Steve Halverson.
Jeff Lochner.
This is Farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
The Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
Thanks for joining us on this special Jackrabbit Insider. Our last classic football finish occurred on November 22, 2008, inside the Fargo Dome. It was the fifth Dakota Marker showdown, with the teams having split the first four. The squads exchanged the lead, with the homestanding Bison taking a 24-17 advantage with 6:32 on the clock. Scott Peters, Kevin Feeney, and Lee Timmerman were behind the microphones on this regional telecast from November of 2008.
And Brody's, 70-some yard return set up South Dakota State's only score.
This is Harris at his 7. Up the middle to the 30, gets across the 30, down at the 32. Barry hands off Manette, gets around a couple of defenders. It's enough for a first down, down to the 43-yard line. Barry this time to pass. Looking downfield, Lardnoy's got him again. Seventh sack of the game for the Bison. Loss of 4 on that play, second and 14 as Barry rolls near side. Throws and almost picked off. Harris looking for the flag and he gets one.
A pass interference, number 4 on the defense.
The result of the penalty is a first down. Jacks with the ball in Bison territory at the 47. Manette, nothing there. Second and 9. 4 wide receivers for the Jacks. Barry in the shotgun. Pressure from behind. Berry now gets rid of it. Over the middle. Harris gets blasted, but held on to the ball. And a flag comes in, which could be a helmet-to-helmet.
I think it might be a high hit.
Issue.
Boy, how did Harris hold on? Maybe he just fell to the ground and the ball landed on top of him, but this is a big pop. Good job by Berry to stay patient.
Hit.
Nope, it wasn't a hit.
And that was Nick Schomer.
No, that was clean. That was clean. Yeah. He hit him with the shoulder.
Cyrus Lemon is the one shaking up.
We have a personal foul. No. Number 36 on the defense. Striking a blow with his helmet. Helmet to helmet contact. First down.
Let's make sure we give credit to Jerron Harris there, though.
Absolutely. Hanging on to that ball. And the result of the penalty now moves the ball all the way down to the 13-yard line of NDSU. First down and 10, 4:15 to go. Jacks trail by 7. Handoff, Manette. Finds a little room, and he gets stood up. Play is stopped at the 11-yard line. Pochart goes in motion. Four receivers for the Jacks. Berry to pass. As Harris, he gets stuck again. Humber makes him down, but it's enough for a first down. First down and goal. Ball on the 2. High formation. Kochart goes in motion. Manette, the carry. And he's down shy of the goal line at the 1. Second and goal from the 1. Berry to throw, looking for Harris. He's got him, and a Jacks touchdown.
There's just so much pressure that when you're someone like Harris, you can put on a defensive back. Well, do I guard the fade? No, you make a nice little move inside. And Berry just rifles this one in here.
Harris's 11th touchdown of the season. Gets his team within 1. And how about this call? 2:20 to go. The Jacks down by 1. They elect to go for the 2 and the lead. 4 wide receivers. Berry in the shotgun. Berry to pass. Fires. Caught. Mike Steffen. 2-point conversion is good. And the Jacks on top by 1.
Go for the win on the road. Similar style of pass play to what the touchdown was. Outside guy making a move to the end.
The final in Fargo that November day, SDSU 25, NDSU 24. We hope you enjoyed this look back at some classic endings to SDSU football games of the past. And for all of us here in the Yeager Media Center studios, I'm Tyler Merriam. We'll see you next time on the Jackrabbit Insider.